completion of this session, so every faculty, so you can able to know what is OBE, what is program educational objective, what are the graduate attributes, then what are the learning outcomes and what are the various levels of outcomes, then sample program outcomes and program specific outcomes. So as a faculty role, so with this knowledge, whatever the course you are handling, you have to know about the course outcomes of your course. So whether the course outcomes are defined or not, okay, after defining end of the course or end of the every unit or every chapter or every module, so whether the student can be able to achieve that particular course outcome or not. So that is the outcome, actually the term outcome based education. Okay, now let us see one by one. So outcome based education, this can be in short named as OBE. So OBE is an educational theory that bases each part of an educational system around goals. In our conventional terminology, we will call it as goal. Now goal becomes in the outcome based education outcome. So whatever the goal we are stating, so that is nothing but in terms of OBE, we'll call it as outcome. So each student should have achieved the goal. So when a particular student achieved his goal, so when the goal by end of the educational experience, if the student is studying a graduation course or post-graduation course, after completion of 3 to 4 years graduation course or 2 to 3 years post-graduation course, so then that student should achieve that outcome, whatever the goals fixed. So OBE is targeted mainly for achieving desirable outcomes in terms of the key terms. First one is knowledge, then second one is skill set, then third one is attitude, and lastly behavior. So at the end of a program, so here another important terminology, so we should aware. Now here we are calling it as a program, then later we will use a course. So we have to know the difference between a program and a course. First we will come to program. A program is nothing but, so in your institution, what are the programs offered at UG level, PG level? Every UG program with a particular specialization, every PG program with a particular specialization, that we will call it as program. So department, we can't call it as program. So department consisting of many programs with UGPG level, for example, BSc Computer Science, then BA Economics, then MSc Data Science, then BSc Information Technology, like that. So maybe you are designating one department. In that department, many programs are there. So that too, UG programs and PG programs. Now program means a particular UG program or a particular PG program, like based on the admissions, how students are choosing the programs. So that we'll call it as programs. So now program wise, first some goals are fixed. So then within that program, then every program, what it contains? Curriculum. We'll call it as curriculum. What curriculum contains? First year to final year level, various courses, some credit related, some non-credit related, some audit courses, then practicals, some comprehensive, Viva, seminar related, project related, internship related, laboratory course. So these are all the combinations in any curriculum. So which can be comprised with all these categories. So now in every program in the curriculum, first year to final year level, whatever the courses included. Now these are all called as now courses in every program, which is a set of courses like first year level to final year level, including practicals, credit, non-credit, so internship, so project, whatever. So all we will call it as courses. So now all these courses, every individual course having course objectives, then course outcomes. So now here in outcome-based education terminology, so now we are talking about outcomes only. So end of every particular course, in the particular semester. So whether whatever the outcomes defined, those are all achieved or not by the learners. So that is the goal, outcome. So that is the main motto of outcome-based education. So now what is program? Now you got clarity. Then what is course? So we got clarity. So now for every program, so there will be some certain goals which are called as outcomes. Those we will call it as program outcomes for a particular program. So BCom specialization 1, 2, 3 and so on. So 10 courses are there. So for each program, outcomes are defined. So some may be common based on the similarity, some may be varied. So based on the program, then every program, what it contains, various courses, then every course, including laboratory, including non-credit courses, every course. So we should define outcomes. So then end of the course, whether those outcomes are achieved or not, that can be assessed by using the concept of computation and attainment. That is the motto of this workshop. Okay, now teaching with this awareness and making the associated effort constitutes outcome-based education. So teaching with this awareness and making the associated effort, so which constitutes outcome-based education. So that is the, in simple terms, OBE. Then this entails a regular methodology for ascertaining the attainment of outcomes. So this is our main theme, attainment of outcomes, how the outcomes are attained or assessed. And by using some benchmarking, these against the program outcomes, which are consistent with the objectives of the program. So your program is the in the particular department, particular program. It may be a UG or PG. For every program, program educational objectives are there, then program outcomes are there, then every course in that program, course outcomes are there. Now course outcomes, which are a subset of program outcomes, then program outcomes, these are all based on the program educational objectives. So then an outcome of an educational program, so is what the student should be able to do at the end of a program or course or instructional unit. Here the three terms, these three are different. Let us see. So end of a program means completion of the course. It may be UG course or PG course, PG program. Then end of a course, whatever the course studying in the current semester, so our upcoming semester. So end of each and every particular course, then instructional unit in a particular course. That course is combination of modules or units. It may be 5, 6, 7, 8, like that, based on the university regulations. So instructional unit is related to a particular course unit wise. Then course is nothing but in your program, a particular subject. We will call it as in simple terms. Subjects are nothing but courses. Then a program is nothing but whatever the program they are studying. It may be UG or PG. So like that. For all these outcomes needs to be attained or able to attain at the end of each of the program, each of the course, each of the instructional unit. So first, a particular unit in a course outcome is achieved means, then by taking the combination of all units outcomes, then that course outcomes are achieved. Then a particular course outcome is achieved. So by all the students of that course who are studying. So then suppose first year to final year level, whatever the courses, if all courses outcomes are achieved at the end of the course, then automatically the program outcomes are achieved. So instructional unit is the dependent of a particular course, then course outcomes are dependent of program outcomes. Like this is the dependency. So now the outcome-based education mainly emphasizes on stating what you want your students to be able to do at the end of the program. So the end of the program, end of the course, end of the instructional unit, this term frequently coming. Let us see. So that is the main theme of outcome-based education. Then assessing the students whether they are able to do what they are expected to do. This is the other factor. Then finally, orienting teaching and other academic process to facilitate students to do what they are expected to do. We have to give the orientation. So with some other academic processes which facilitate students to do what they are expected to do. So these are all the main factors where OBE is focused. So then here you can see one layered structure which comprises of various factors involved. First, for a particular institution or organization, first we have to see the what is the vision of the organization or institute, then what is the mission. Even you can take program also, like a department also having a vision of the department, mission of the department. Department, vision and mission, so which are aligned with the institute vision and mission. So we are all working to achieve the mission of our institution by following the institute vision. Like that, program to program, that is the department to department, we have to define vision and mission separately. So then for every program means like whatever the specializations, UG or PG. So we have to define program educational objectives. So department educational objectives not related to each and every individual programs. So every individual specialization, UG, PG, separately have to define program educational objectives. So by seeing a particular department vision and mission, then every department vision and mission, so aligned with the institute vision and mission. So then once program educational objectives are defined for a particular program, then the goals now onwards we'll call it as program outcomes. So program outcomes commonly you can define for each and every program. So aligned with some of the accreditation agencies like NAC, NBA, etc. So then by using Washington Accord, so USA, that is the ABET International Accreditation Agency. So as per their guidelines, the program outcomes are standardized. So they have separately defined, simply we have to follow the program outcomes without any alteration. So we can't do any altering. So as it is, we have to follow as per the regulatory bodies. So then program specific outcomes. So these are all specific to your particular program. Suppose program outcomes generally for engineering courses, 12 program outcomes are there. For a general education, 6 to 7, even for a postgraduate course, management courses, so 6 to 8 or 9, like that. This is the general count of program outcomes. Then program specific outcomes, which are purely related to your particular program. But these are all again subset of program outcomes only. These are all not new. But so you can't take all program outcomes as program specific outcomes. Suppose a particular specialization, management, finance, arts, commerce. So commerce may meet only some program outcomes exclusively. So for the current program, whatever the program offering, even for economics, so economics related only some program outcomes purely. So that only you can make it as specific outcomes. So you can define separately. So generally 2 to 4 program specific outcomes are defined. Then anyway, course outcome for every course in each and every program, course outcomes are defined. So now this is the hierarchy. First, we have to see vision, mission, then program educational objectives, then outcomes, program specific outcomes, finally course outcomes. Now in the reverse order for attainment, first we have to do course outcomes attainment, then after completion of all courses outcomes attainment, then we have to do program outcomes attainment, then program specific outcomes attainment. So then the program educational objectives so are fulfilled by the attainment of the program outcomes, specific outcomes and course outcomes. Finally, so we fulfilled the vision or mission of the department, then finally institute vision and mission, like that. This is the order we have to follow. So then coming to our next terminology, program educational objectives. So in the previous diagram, whatever the terms you mentioned, each and every term will define with some examples. So program educational objectives, which are the statements. So those describes the expected achievements of graduates. So this is a very important key term, expected achievements of graduates within first few years. It may be generally 3 to 5 of their graduation from the program. So expected achievements, like our aim. So our aim is to achieve so and so. So these are all expectations, whether we have reached our expectations or not. So that is nothing but outcome. So now, program educational objectives, which are broad statements, so that describe the career and professional accomplishments. So career and professional accomplishments. So that the program is preparing graduates to achieve. So for this, the reference is taken from NBA, National Board of Accreditation. So manual, this is the link given. So they have defined so about this program educational objectives based on the Washington Accord, that is ABET accreditation agency. Even NAC also followed same NBA manual. So then program educational objectives will address the following broad aspects. So here the following aspects are mentioned by using some questionnaire type. So what our graduates could do best, then how our graduates would approach problem solving, using what skills, then what values our graduates should have after entering professional life. So these are all the main broad aspects. So where program educational objectives will address. So then let us see some sample program educational objectives. So which are taken for a particular engineering course related to computer science. This is just for reference only. So with this, you can define your program educational objectives. So the first one, graduates of computer science and engineering, or any graduate, so this is applicable, will have a successful career in technology or managerial functions. So the graduates of computer science, you can rename with your department. So the graduates of management, the graduates of arts, the graduates of commerce, etc. So every graduate will have successful career in their technology or managerial functions. That is program educational objective one. Then another one, the graduates of the program will have solid technical and professional foundation to continue higher studies. So this is also, suppose any UG graduate student, so wants to pursue higher studies in or abroad. So with the knowledge what they achieved in the graduation course. So for that, the graduates of the program will have solid, that means strong technical and professional foundation to continue higher studies. So now here, all the program educational objectives must state the graduates of so-and-so, like that. So that is the higher studies is the second program educational objective. So then third one, the graduates of the program will have skills to develop products and offer services and create new knowledge, development of the product, development of the system, and become entrepreneurs to start their own business, to develop their ideas. So like that. So the graduates of the program will have skills to develop the products and offer services related to their areas. So here, creates a new knowledge. So new knowledge is the key term. So then next one, the graduates of the program will have fundamental awareness of industry process, tools and technologies. So any graduation, so whatever they are studying, so their final goal is they have to place in good MNC. So it may be a software field in that IT sector, or product based, or their subject domain related areas. It may be a management related, HR, finance, marketing, like that, etc. So then they have to get the knowledge, fundamental awareness of what are the industries offered, the courses, what you studied, related jobs, your core jobs, then what are the tools and technologies they are used in the current market trend, what are the latest emerging technologies, whether so we are meeting those technologies or not. So in the due of study of the course, so we have to acquire the knowledge of the industry process and tools and technologies, then only you will be survived. So like that, they have to fix their goals. So these are all the, some sample program educational objectives. So here, in our program also, you may alter based on that program. So every program, successful career is common. So higher studies, suppose UG to higher study is PG. Then PG students, they may go for MPhil or PhD, like that. So higher study is also applicable for all the programs. Then new knowledge, okay, every program, new knowledge is also related. Then industry process, tools and technology also related. So these key terms meets all the program's requirements. Like that, we have to define by making the graduates of, by using this terminology. So these are some of the sample program educational objectives. Okay, now next important term, graduate attributes. So actually the term outcome derived from the graduate attribute only. Now here, what are the graduate attributes? So graduate attributes form a set of individually assessable outcomes that are the components indicative of the graduate's potential to acquire competence to practice at the appropriate level. So these are all which forms a set of individually assessable outcomes. So whatever the outcomes specifying or defining, so every outcome needs to be assessed or attained individually. So with the indicative of graduates' potential, their knowledge, their acquirement. So finally, to acquire competence to practice at the appropriate level. Now the graduate attributes, which are examples of the attributes expected of a graduate from an accredited program. So the graduate attributes of the NBA, as per the NBA terminology, so the following table shows various graduate attributes. So now even for general higher education also, so some of the graduate attributes are adopted and defined their program outcomes. So now, as for the accreditation body, so the following are the graduate attributes. The first one is the order also we have to follow, the same order. The first one, basic knowledge, engineering knowledge. If it is technical, so then engineering knowledge. If it is general education, so then there also knowledge on their domains. Then problem analysis, problems occur in all domains. So how to analyze the problems. Then design and development of solutions. Once problem is identified, so you can recall once, so if you are pursuing PhD or whoever completed doctorates, so the life cycle, the phases in the process of completion of a thesis. So first what you have to do, so we have to identify our problem statement. Once problem statement is identified, then you have to define, so or develop the prototype or mathematical modeling. So then with that, we have to use some methodologies. Then we have to investigate. Then you have to apply some modern tools for implementation. So then finally, after implementation, then how this is useful to the society. Then you have to consider some of the factors, environment, ethics. So then finally, whether with this knowledge, future enhancement, future work, like. So any thesis, any publication, you can see the order of the contents. So in the similar fashion, so the graduate attributes also are defined. So the first one is engineering knowledge or knowledge on any area. It may be general education or management related or technical or non-technical, whatever. The knowledge on the domains. Then problem analysis, analyzing the problem. Then design and development of solutions for solving the problem identified. Then conducting investigations of complex problems, doing some analysis, some research. Then for implementation point of view, using some modern tool. So as of current marketing requirements, what are the latest technologies or tools? So if you can incorporate, if you can use, you can gain that knowledge. With that knowledge, you may sustain further, so to get good positions or good jobs meeting the industry requirements. Then the engineer and society, so after graduation, not only engineer, so any graduate, so how they are useful to the society, so without harming, so what good they are doing, so engineer and society. Then the environment and sustainability, so whatever we are creating, so whatever we are doing, we have to take care of, we have to protect our environment, then we have to sustain. So there is another important factor. So then ethics means moralities, so human values and personal ethics needs to be followed. So whatever the work we are doing, whether we are doing with genuine, so without copying, so from others, like that. So ethical values needs to be followed. Then individual and teamwork. So individual, whether you are doing so at your own or as part of team. So suppose students' perspective, students may be divided into groups. So even for doing practical experiment also, so they may grouped into table wise, one group like that. So then commonly they will share the resources available. Then they will discuss according to team wise, like that. Even whenever UG students, they are doing project work. So UG project is combination of teams with 2 to 4 members. Then PG is individual project. So like that, PG is the example of individual and the UG project is the teamwork related. Then communication. Communication means everyone thinks communication is like English. So not only English, whatever we are communicating. So even when students giving seminar, so then when students attending for project Viva Voss, so then even laboratory also, they are discussing about that experiment. So communication. So communication meets all these factors like presentations, even project dissertations, so even for experiments, so like that, many factors meets the communication. Then project management and finance. Project management, so once the project is completed, so then how to implement it, then how to overcome the errors occurred, so whenever that was implemented, then the budget related to that project, so future plan, like short term, long term plans with the finance perspective. Then the customers, whether they satisfied or not. So if they didn't satisfied, so you have to take the feedback, then whatever the problems they address, you have to rectify, you have to overcome. That continuous support is required. So all comes under management and finance related. Then lastly, lifelong learning. The last one is lifelong learning. So any student or any faculty or any learner, so day to day, we have to learn, we have to acquire the new skills, new knowledge. So to bridge the gap between industry and academia. So every day, so we are all learners. So that's why lifelong learning is essential. So these are all the 12 graduate attributes defined by accreditation bodies. Now these graduate attributes now becomes outcomes. So those can be numbered with the same order. Let us see. Now the graduate attributes becomes program outcomes. In the previous, whatever we mentioned, 12 graduate attributes now becomes program outcomes in outcome-based education. So before outcome-based education, that is before 2011, so OBE was not there. At that time, we are calling it as the graduate attributes only, with the serial number. So now whenever the OBE was in picture, so at that time, now the graduate attributes are converted into outcomes. Now we'll call it as every graduate attribute, now we'll call it as program outcome. The program outcomes are numbered with 1 to 12. Now every outcome we have to prefix PO. So PO1, that is program outcome 1, PO2, program outcome 2, and so on, PO12, program outcome 12. So the same 12 graduate attributes we have taken, now the same order, so numbering is given. Now these are all becomes program outcomes. Okay, now so that is the concept of program outcome. Then coming to learning outcome. So what is learning outcome? Learning outcomes are specific intentions of a program or module written in clear terms. So learning outcomes means, so whenever a particular student studying a particular course, so what are those course outcomes? So then finally end of that course, whether those outcomes are achieved or not in due of the course, so those outcomes are achieved or not. Now, which are all specific intentions of your program? A program is that may be a UG or PG or a module. So written in clear terms, module means a particular unit for a particular course. So then this describes what a student should know, understand, or be able to do at the end of the program or module. These are all learning outcomes. Now, various types of learning outcomes are there. So program outcomes is also one learning outcome. Then course outcome is also one learning outcome. Then program specific outcome is also learning outcome. Those are all called as levels of learning outcomes. So don't confuse. Learning outcomes are nothing but the three types of outcomes: program outcomes, program specific outcomes, course outcomes. So finally, these learning outcomes describe what a student should know, understand, or be able to do at the end of the program or module. So you may already aware of course outcomes. For every course in our curriculum, outcomes are defined starting of that particular course. So I have visited your website also, I have seen. So all these are already defined. There you can see the course outcomes, every course outcome, it should start with the phrase. So student should be able to do at the end of the course or end of the program. So start with this sentence, then followed by various course outcomes. So then levels of outcomes. So here program outcomes is the one level, then program specific outcome is the next level, then course outcomes. So program outcomes, just now we already covered. Program outcomes are the statements that describe what the student graduating from any of the educational programs should be able to do, whatever the course they are studying. Then program specific outcomes, which are statements that describe what the graduates of specific educational program. So here the first one, program outcome, is general educational program. Then specific educational program means, so your core area related outcomes of that program, those are called as specific program specific outcomes. So PSOs are the statements that describe what the graduates of specific educational program. Specialization, specific means specialized program to program based on the specialization should be able to do. This is the difference between program outcome and program specific outcome. But this specific educational program outcomes also subset of program outcomes only, but not all, only some of them. Then coming to course outcome. Course outcome means whatever the courses they are studying in the part of the program, first year to final year. So your course outcomes are the statements that describe what students should be able to do at the end of a course. Course outcome means what students should be able to do at the end of the course. Then program specific outcome means at the end of the course, what students should be able to do with the specific educational program. Then for general program outcomes, so the educational program should be able to do. So these are all the three levels of outcomes. Now, in the process of computation and attainment, these three levels are essential. So then coming to program outcomes. So now previously graduate attributes are now converted into program outcomes. So now the full sentences, let us review once here. Program outcomes are what knowledge, skills, and attitudes a graduate should have at the time of graduation. So we'll know agency has formally defined the POs of general higher education. So with the 3-year degree program in India, let us see. So this is related to you. So no agency has formally defined the program outcomes of general higher education in 3 years degree programs in India. So POs of all professional programs in engineering and other areas are identified at national level by the concerned accrediting agency. So now POs are not specific to a discipline. So these are all common for all the programs. Specific means those are all program specific outcomes. So now POs are narrower statements that describe what students are expected to know upon the graduation. So these relate to the skills, knowledge, and behavior or attitude that students acquire in their matriculation through the program. So the same we already explained. Then program outcomes should not be too broad. They must align with graduate attributes. They must reflect all graduate attributes. So anyway, all the graduate attributes are now converted into program outcomes. So now, so whatever the 12 graduate attributes we discussed, now those are all converted into program outcomes. Here I have collected the sample engineering degree program outcomes with same 12 graduate attributes. So here the labeling can be done with PO1, that is program outcome 1, program outcome 2, and so on, 12 program outcomes. So whatever the 12 graduate attributes discussed previously, the full sentences are given. So here the highlighted color starting headings, let us see, those are all the graduate attributes terminologies. So engineering knowledge. So here in place of engineering knowledge, you may take the basic knowledge. So here you can see even technical, non-technical, all knowledges are included. The sentence, let us see, apply the knowledge of mathematics, science, engineering fundamentals, and an engineering specialization to the solution of complex engineering problems. So here the knowledge, mathematics, science, even management, whatever, all the knowledges you can include here. Then problem analysis. So identify, formulate, review research literature. So every keyword is very important here in these sentences. And analyze the complex engineering problem or general problems, reaching substantiated conclusions using first principles of mathematics or natural science or some other areas. Then design and development of solutions. Design solutions for complex engineering problems and design system components or process that meet the specified needs with appropriate consideration for public health, safety, and the cultural, societal, and environmental considerations. So even for design and development here, so the engineering society, ethics, environment, and sustainability all are included in this. Then conduct investigations of complex problems using some research-based knowledge and research methods, including design of experiments, analysis and interpretation of data, then synthesis of the information to provide valid conclusions. Then modern tool usage, create, select, apply appropriate techniques, resources, and modern engineering or general tools, including prediction and modeling to complex problems. So with an understanding of the limitations. So then the engineer and society, apply reasoning informed by contextual knowledge to assess societal health, safety, legal, and cultural issues, and the consequent responsibilities relevant to the professional practice. So engineer and society, see the key terms involved here. Then environment and sustainability, understand the impact of the professional engineering solutions or general solutions in a societal and environmental context and demonstrate the knowledge of and need for sustainable development. Then ethics, apply ethical principles and commit to professional ethics and responsibilities and norms for the whatever the practice, engineering or any general practice. Then individual and teamwork, function effectively as an individual and as member or leader in diverse teams and in multidisciplinary settings. Then communication, communicate effectively on complex problems, engaging community with the societal, such as being able to comprehend or write effective reports or design documentation or make effective presentations even while preparing our presentation also, and give and receive clear instructions. All are related to communication. Then project management and finance, demonstrate knowledge and understanding of the engineering and management principles and apply those to one's own work as a member and a leader in a team to manage projects in multidisciplinary environments. Then lifelong learning, recognize the need for and have the preparation and ability to engage in an independent and lifelong learning in the broad context of technological change. So whenever new technologies are introduced, so we have to adapt, we have to acquire, so by learning, lifelong learning. Okay, now some sample POs for general higher education, so which meets you. So the PO1 is critical thinking. So this I have taken from NAC manual only. So PO1 critical thinking, then PO2 effective communication. This was already covered in the 12 graduate attributes. then social interaction, effective citizenship, ethics also covered, environment and sustainability is also covered, then self-directed and lifelong learning. So here 1 to 7, so all 12 graduate attributes won't meet for a general higher education programs. So critical thinking. So here, take informed actions after identifying the assumptions that frame our thinking and actions, checking out the degree to which these assumptions are accurate and valid, and looking at our ideas and decisions like intellectual, organizational, personal from different perspective. Then effective communication, same as in our previous outcome. Speak, read, write, and listen clearly in person and through electronic media in English and in one Indian language, and make meaning of the world by connecting people, ideas, books, media, and technology. Then social interaction, elicit views of others, then mediate disagreements and help reach conclusions in group settings. This is a social interaction, societal. Then effective citizenship, demonstrate empathetic social concern and equity, center national development, and the ability to act with an informed awareness of the issues and participate in civic life through volunteering. Then ethics, recognize different value system including your own, understand the moral dimensions of your decisions and accept responsibility for them. Then environment and sustainability, understand the issues of environmental context and sustainable development. Then self-directed and lifelong learning, acquire the ability to engage in independent and lifelong learning in the broadest context, socio-technological changes. So as for previous 12 graduate attributes, communication, then ethics, environment, lifelong learning, 4 so taken from the same. So remaining meeting with the general higher education. Now coming to program specific outcomes, for example, here I have collected some samples for undergraduate program in computer science and engineering. So as a computer science graduation, now everyone should require the computer knowledge. First, any knowledge, mathematical background is essential. Without mathematics, so nothing is there. So foundation of mathematical concepts. Then as a computer science graduate, it may be UG, Bachelor of Science in Computer Science, MSc in Information Technology, Information Science. So foundation of computer system is required. So with the basic foundation of computer system, so the graduates able to develop the software products. It may be apps, like nowadays we are very much interested in the creation of the apps through mobile, Android app, so etc., even web application. So now everything is converted into mobile app. In Play Store, we are downloading and installing, then we are using. So those are all applications, apps. So with the basic knowledge of mathematical and computer, then those products are developed. So like, see, specific outcomes are just 2 to 3 or 2 to 4 maximum. So only specific to that particular program specialization. So then here some other BA economics I have collected. So program specific outcomes, this also I have taken from NAC manual. So PSO1 defined is understand the behavior of Indian and world economy. That is one program specific outcome. So which meets specific to economics. Then PSO2, analyze macroeconomic policies, including fiscal and monetary policies in India. This also economic related. Then PSO3, determine economic variables, including inflation, unemployment, poverty, GDP, balance of payments using statistical methods. This is also purely economics related. Then PSO4, understand the behavior of financial and money markets and perform cost benefit analysis for making investment decisions. So these are all some sample specific outcomes to BA economics course. So like that, now you may got idea. So how to define program specific outcomes specific to a particular program. So then coming to course outcomes, here I have taken some sample course outcomes. One is for technical and one is for general education course. So now here I have taken one course in UG Computer Science Engineering related formal languages and automated theory. So this course, so related to some mathematical as well as computational. So mathematical knowledge is 50%, computational knowledge is 50%. That's why So this is somewhat related to mathematical subject. So now here in this, let us say the CO1, COs are numbered like this, course outcome 1, course outcome 2, and so on. So as for accreditation bodies, so the general count of defining course outcomes for a particular course, so at least minimum 4 to 6. This is the general ideal count of course outcomes for a particular course, 4 to 6. So even some courses, maybe they defined 7, 8, 9, 10 also. So you have to minimize it. Generally, unit or module wise, one course outcome you can define. So that is the ideal. So generally, every course consisting of 5 units. Worst case, so you may take one unit comprising of 2 modules or 2 sub concepts. At that time, you can define separately 4 to 6 or 4 to 8 like that. So ideal count you have to maintain. So understand the concept of abstract machines. So here, the knowledge of machine and power to recognize a particular language. Then employ a finite state machine for modeling and solving computing problems. Then design some grammars for formal languages. Then knowledge on converting a particular grammar into its machine. Then understand the power of a Turing machine with its abstract automaton, which describes computation effectively and efficiently. Computation, you can remember, just. Then distinguish between decidable and undecidable. This everyone know. What is decidable? What is undecidable? So this can be defined with respect to problem. A problem is said to be decidable, also called as solvable, whenever there exists an algorithm or an approach, a procedure to solve that problem. Then the problem is said to be decidable. Undecidable or unsolvable, there is no algorithm, there is no approach, there is no method to solve a particular problem. So like these are all the sample course outcomes for a technical computer science engineering related course. Now here I have taken one general course for BCom, that is environmental studies. The course outcomes are, so this I have taken from your college website only, your course only. So I have copied the same outcomes from your website. This environmental studies course in the BCom first year level, it is there in our website. So recollect 4 basic spheres of environment and their interlinkages with the geographical diversity. So this is one course outcome related to environmental study. Then understand the role of man in environment, that is the role of humans. Then sense the myth of human supremacy on the earth. Then realize the need of environment protection and resource conservation. Then implement some steps of environmental protection and resource conservation, etc. Then comprehend the ill effects if environment is not protected. Then initiate environmental related activity in his vicinity. So like, see here, the ideal count of course outcomes, like 4 to 6 or 4 to 8, like that, based on the course syllabus. So these are the sample course outcomes of the BCom course, environmental studies. Okay, with this, now I will stop here. Just we will review what we discussed till now as part of day one session. First here, we addressed the simplest introduction about outcome-based education, then program educational objectives, then graduate attributes, then graduate attributes to program outcomes, then learning outcomes, various levels of learning outcomes like program outcomes, program-specific outcomes, course outcomes. Then we demonstrated some sample program outcomes and program-specific outcomes and course outcomes. So with this, now I stop here.